So as promised, here I am looking for the best laptops, gaming laptops, to make your Sims 4 game run faster. Basically, we have a whole bunch of laptops over here. The one thing that you need to keep in mind whenever you're looking to buy a laptop is that it needs to be a gaming laptop. And just a disclaimer for you guys, I am not under any circumstances promoting one, you know, brand over another, and I am definitely not an informatician. I really enjoy, you know, discussing techie stuff. I'm just recommending, you know, laptops based off their specifications. I truly hope it makes sense. I'm using Amazon this time just because it is a universal platform, if you will, and it's much easier for me to basically present you a model. But here I am looking for laptops. We're gonna firstly go for the, you know, entry level price range, which is around $400. It is not that cheap, but this is an entry level laptop that you can use. So this is the Asus laptop, and as you can see right here, if we go into the techie details, we can see that it has dedicated card, graphics card, which is what we are looking for. We don't want to buy an integrated card because this won't run our game as it should. It also has 8 gigs of RAM, which is also a criteria that you need to look for, and it also has 128 gigs of SSD. This is not a best laptop, okay? This is an entry level laptop. It isn't even categorized as being a gaming laptop, but I tried my best to incorporate, you know, laptops that have different, you know, price ranges. For an entry level laptop, I think it's pretty decent. If we look at this other laptop over here, you can see that this one has an integrated card, which means that it isn't going to run our game as it should. So always, always, always look for dedicated graphic cards. I'm also curious to see something about this processor because it is a quad core processor, and I was basically curious about the release date. For this price range, it is no surprise that that specific processor was released in 2016. I think we're better off if we search laptop and then go to filters. So you really wanna filter by dedicated graphics type. This is a must. And we also wanna have at least 8 gigs of RAM. Okay, let's sort by the lowest price and see what we got in here. If you want to go over that budget, if you have $100 more to spare for a laptop, this is obviously better than the other one that I presented because it has a way better, you know, processor. It also has 256 gigabytes of SSD, but keep in mind that this is renewed, so it isn't new. If you're okay with that, you can definitely go for this model. It also has a 14 inches display, which is slightly smaller than the other one. It has 6 processors, which is way better than the other one, a way bigger SSD. We also have the very same, you know, RAM. And this is how it looks. And I really like that it has a backlit keyboard. And let's look up this processor. It is a hexa-core processor, which means that it has 6 cores. And it was released in March 2020, which is obviously way better than the other one. Okay, another option for you in terms of gaming laptops would be this MSI thin laptop, which is in the 700 price range. It is definitely a lot pricier than the other ones, but it's definitely better because we have a 4 gigabytes dedicated graphics card, which will ensure that your games will run faster. Okay, there we go into the techie stuff. So we have an Intel Core processor. If you're, you know, just used to having Intel processors, you can go for this one. But if you're okay with AMD, you can definitely go for that one as well. Keep in mind that the MAD's processors will get slightly hotter than these ones. Also, this processor has been released in 2019, which is so great. Basically, whenever you're looking for a gaming laptop, it all comes down to the processor, to the graphics card, to the, you know, ROM that it has, and to the type of hard drive that it has, because it can be like an HDD, which won't run as fast, or it can be an SSD, which will basically mean that your operating system, meaning your Windows, will load a lot faster. So definitely go for SSD, or you can go for a laptop that has an HDD, and then you can replace it with an SSD later on if you are willing to, you know, just invest a little bit more into your laptop. We also have this Lenovo IdeaPad gaming laptop, which just looks so nice. Look at this marketing, you guys. We have so many specs out here. It is so sleek, and it's also within the $600-$700 price range, which isn't that much. So it has 6 processor cores. It is an AMD Ryzen processor. It also has a 120 hertz refresh rate, which means that your game will run a lot smoother on your screen. It also is full HD. We also have a cool and, you know, performant thermal system, which means that your laptop won't get as hot. However, it's always best, especially when you're playing games on laptops, to have a cooler on hand. A webcam with a privacy shutter. You have, you know, the power input, the Ethernet port, HDMI. If you want to connect your laptop to a TV or to a bigger screen, and it also has a USB Type-C, which means that you can basically transfer files way quicker than you would do on the regular USB, you know, 2.0 or 3.0. Onto the techie stuff, you guys. So you always need to look at the RAM, okay? At least 8 RAM, and the faster the memory speed of that specific RAM, the better. Know that this is a 3200 megahertz, which is so nice. We also have RAMs that have the 2666 megahertz, which is obviously lower than this one, so this is great. We also have an SSD, not an HDD. It is a dedicated card, and I'm pretty sure this is a 4 GB graphics card, which is okay for the entry level. And more on this processor, it has a frequency of 3.3 GHz. You want that processor frequency to be at least, you know, 2.5 to 2.6, but the higher the better. Let's see what laptops we can find with a 6 GB, you know, graphics card, because the regular graphics card for gaming laptops is the 4 GB one, which won't get you as much. It is okay for the average consumer, but if you want your game to run even better, just shoot for a 6 GB graphics card. Okay, so we have this Dell gaming laptop, which is also in the same price range of $600-$700. The condition is like new. I like that it has a 6 GB video memory. Like, this is what you should shoot for. So basically, the 4 GB video memory is the lowest, then you have 6 GB, and then you have 8 GB, which is so good. You also have on the other side of the spectrum probably 11 GB of video memory, but if you want to look for those kind of laptops, those will be a lot pricier. Like, we're talking about $2,000 or even more. We want to be sensible when we are making these decisions. Like, we don't want to pay for something that is overpriced, if that makes any sense. But this is such a good deal. You know, the only drawback is the fact that it has been used. Here we go. As I said, we have 8 GB of RAM, but you see, like, this memory speed is way lower. But on the other hand, we have such a fast, you know, SSD. It is a 256 GB SSD. The fact that we have 6 GB of video memory makes this laptop so worth it. I've always loved, you know, Asus gaming laptops, just because those aren't like as overpriced as other brands. This costs around $850. So we are going a little bit overboard. This is within the $800-$900 price range. Let's take a look at the specs. For this price, you will get a 6 GB video memory, which is so nice. It is the best, you know, memory, video memory that you can get for this price. We have an SSD, we have a 256 SSD, as well as 1 TB HDD, which is so nice. We have so much space for games. By the way, if you didn't know, it is always best to install your apps/your operating system, namely your Windows, on the SSD, because your apps and your laptop will load a lot faster. When it comes to files, it's always best to put them on the HDD, because those files don't require such a high, you know, reading speed. Again, we also have this MSI thin gaming laptop. It is so sleek. I think this is new, right? It is new. And here we go. Here are the specs. So we get 6 GB of video memory, which is always the best. We have 256 GB of memory. You know, you get the regular 15 inches screen. It has a refresh rate of 144 Hz, which is so good. So let's see what laptops with, you know, 8 GB of video memory are out there. I'm pretty curious. I'm pretty sure that those are going to be so expensive. I have always loved the ROG Strix laptops, gaming laptops. Like, it has the full HD display, has 144 Hz, which means that your gameplay will be smooth. We have an AMD Ryzen 7 processor, which is pretty new. We have 8 GB of RAM, and look at the frequency of this processor. It is a 4.2 GHz. I think that is the max. Like, if you overclock it, you'll potentially attain this frequency. I'm not pretty sure if it is the regular one or the overclocked one. And you also get 512 GB worth of SSD, which is plenty of space for all of your games. It is in the $900 range. One brand or one model that I was always looking for when it comes to gaming laptops is the Asus TUFi. It is quite affordable for what it offers. Again, this is in the $800-$900 price range. Look at the keyboard. So we have 8 GB with a speed of 2933 MHz, which is still good. We have 500 GB worth of SSD. We have a dedicated video card, 4 GB video memory. It is quite expensive. So moving on to the European Amazon, because I know that there are people out there from Europe that might want to invest or purchase a brand new gaming laptop for holidays. And I know that the very same models, you know, won't be shown on the European Amazon. The US prices are so, like, affordable. I couldn't find anything better than this one in this price range, which is around, you know, 500-600 euros. This is not the best, definitely, and I've never heard of this brand before, which is the Koo laptop. It might be a brand that just, you know, buys or purchases components and then it just makes this whole laptop. So I wouldn't recommend that you buy this one, but I thought it would be nice to show an affordable, you know, option as well. This is not what you should strive for, because I'm not very convinced by this brand. You do get indeed an AMD Ryzen processor, you do get, you know, 8 GB worth of RAM, you do get a 500 GB SSD, but when it comes to electronics, it's always best to opt for, you know, well-known brands. So I just switched to the Amazon France website, because I couldn't find anything, you know, that meets the criteria that I'm looking for. So let's just sort by jeu, which means gaming, or we should better type in, you know, gaming laptop 4 gigabytes graphics. Like, if you're looking for a particular criteria, just type in that search field, you know, gaming laptop, and then, you know, 5 gigabytes or 6 gigabytes or 8 gigabytes, you know, video memory, because this is what we are particularly looking for. Those are so pricey. Afficher tout, informatique et bureau, and we can select the gaming, you know, category. PC et réalité virtuelle. Let's just take a look at this. For the 700, you know, 800 euros price range, I think this is the best, you know, laptop that you can get for this type of money. You get a Ryzen processor, you get 16 gigabytes of RAM, you get a pretty large SSD. It isn't obviously the best when it comes to gaming. It isn't categorized as being a gaming laptop. Like, see, this is the integrated graphics card. If you have 100 euros more to spare, definitely go for a better, you know, alternative, because if you want to play games, you really need a gaming laptop. You cannot play games, you know, decently on personal or office laptops. This is the very first option that I have for you. This is a Lenovo IdeaPad gaming laptop. We have a single photo and we have 6 processors, and the speed of the processor is 4.0 gigahertz, which is so good. 500 gigabytes worth of SSD. We also have this graphics card, which is a 4 gigabytes graphics card, which is not the best. The best, in my opinion, is the 6 gigabytes graphics card, if we are taking into consideration the price range as well. One more model that caught my eye is this Dell G3 gaming laptop. So we have a pretty new generation processor because it is the 10th generation of Intel Core. We also have a 144 hertz type of display, which is again so good for gaming. We have 8 gigabytes of RAM, but you can always upgrade your RAM and make it bigger by buying a RAM stick if your specific laptop has like 2 slots for RAM, and if it supports more than, you know, 8 gigabytes of RAM, obviously. For this price, I really like that you get a 6 gigabytes graphics card. La mémoire maximale est de 16 gigabytes, which means that you can obviously buy another slot and make your laptop be a 16 gigabytes gaming laptop. Oh my gosh. You guys, I cannot express how much I love this brand. This Acer Predator type of model has always been on my wish list. Like, this Helios series has definitely caught my eyes, just because, like, look at the keyboard. You also get for this price a 6 gigabyte video card. You get the 144 hertz refresh rate screen, you get a full HD screen, and you also get a 6-core Intel processor and also 16 gigabytes worth of RAM and 256 gigabytes worth of SSD. Like, this, in my opinion, is really, really worth the money for that particular, you know, video card, because we are always looking for 6 gigabytes video cards, okay? Just keep that in mind. The 4 gigabytes ones are the entry level ones, are not the best, but definitely are better than the integrated graphics card that most laptops come with. Again, this is another alternative, also from Acer Predator, a slightly newer version, because we also have the RTX graphics card and also a newer generation processor. Just to sum up, you guys, if you're looking to play, you know, Sims 4 or any other game really that also comes with many DLCs, when I'm saying DLCs, I'm referring to expansion packs such as, I don't know, seasons, such as Snowy Escape, such as Island Living, such as Cottage Living, you get what I'm saying. If you are planning to, you know, play games, hardcore games, I wouldn't say that Sims is a hardcore game, but if you're a gamer, you definitely need to buy a Windows laptop. These are the following criteria that you should look for whenever you are picking a laptop. you should take a look at the video memory. The higher, the better. You also need to take a look at the RAM that that specific laptop has. You should also take a look at the screen. So you need to pick a full HD, you know, type of screen. And if it also has a 144 or 144Hz refresh rate, it is even better. Moving on to storage, it's always best to pick a laptop that has an SSD. We are also looking at the processor because we want to have a processor that is quite new, that has at least, you know, 4 or 6 cores, which means that it can be a quad core processor, a 6-core processor, or even better, an octa-core processor, but these are definitely pricier. You should also take a look at the memory speed of your RAM. And last but not least, you should also take a look at the frequency of the processor. So we're talking about 3.0 gigahertz, we're looking for 4.0 gigahertz, we're looking for 3.6 gigahertz. But if there's one criteria that you should really, like, really take into consideration, I would say that the video memory is the most crucial one alongside RAM. The best combo would be like a 6 gigabytes, you know, video memory laptop with like 16 gigabytes RAM memory. If you liked this type of content, please make sure to subscribe, like, comment, all that good jazz. Hit that notification bell to be notified whenever I'm uploading a new video, because it truly, truly helps me a lot. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next time with a brand new, exciting, and helpful video for you. Have an awesome day, just like you. Bye, guys. Thank you.